All right, welcome back to Cultivating Connections. Tonight, we have a number of great performances, but that's not my job to tell you. That is our host for the evening, our hostess with the mostest, Chris Hamp, National Grange Lecturer. And so I will turn this program over to her. Chris, welcome back to Date Night In.
Hey, there we are. Welcome back. It is Date Night In 11.0. Who would have ever thought that we would be doing this 11 weeks from when we started 11 weeks ago? So it is Saturday, the 13th of June. Tomorrow's Flag Day. So happy Flag Day, everyone. And tonight we have, like Amanda said, another great lineup for you covering all corners of the country. So I'm looking forward to another great night. Are we ready to charge ahead? Yep, all right. Well, tonight the opening act comes to us from Texas. Corinne Overstreet is a member of Alamo Grange number 1446 and is the secretary of the Texas State Grange. Sister Corinne currently teaches English and reading at the elementary level at a small private school. She enjoys signing for recreation and has performed sign of songs since she was 7. Please make welcome Sister Corinne Overstreet. Corinne.
Hi, I'm Corinne, and I'm going to be signing Death Was Arrested by Laura Story.
Alone in my sorrow and dead in my sin, lost without hope with no place to begin. Your love made a way to let mercy come in. When death was arrested, my life began. When death was arrested, my life began. Oh, your grace, so free, washes over me. You have made me new. Release from my chains, I'm a prisoner now. My shame was a ransom, be faithful to God. He canceled my debt and he called me his friend. One day was arrested, my life began.
Yes, Lord, pour
I see that it's laid on a criminal's cross. Darkness rejoices and heaven has lost.
Corinne, thank you very much. That was beautiful. Thanks for coming on and joining us and sharing your talents and love for signing, which is so very obvious with the rest of us. Just absolutely great. Thank you very much. All right, folks. Next up is Joan C. Smith. Sister Joan is a sixth generation Granger with 60 years of membership, plus another 5 in the junior Grange. She served as president at both the community and Pomona level in New Jersey and was on their state junior Grange committee for 26 years. In 2000, her career with the Department of Defense took her to the Pentagon, and she retired in 2013 with 33 years of service. Thank you, Joan. She currently serves as president of Potomac Grange No. 1 in Washington, D.C., and is chair of the National Grange Foundation Board. In New Jersey, she currently belongs to Farmingdale Grange No. 157 and serves as a regional deputy. So tonight, Sister Joan has agreed to come on, and it's a little bit different than anything you've seen in the previous 10 weeks. Sister Joan has agreed to do some spontaneous public speaking tonight, where she's also allowed Sister Amanda and I to come up with the topics for her. So some bravery points for Joan right there, I think. So Joan, I'm gonna start with mine, and it is definitely the softball. So the first topic for you this evening is to tell us.
I think we're having a little bit of technical difficulties.
Yes, it looks like
with
it.
Joan. And so she is struggling to hear us at the moment, which is probably good because, you know, then she can make up anything she wants in this discussion, right? All right. So, Joan, you may need to try your volume. And if that doesn't seem to work, then we might have to come back and go to your next performance. And then come back to Joe.
Oren, are you close? Next performer has left his screen, so.
There he is.
There he is. All right. So let's give Joan a chance to figure something out. And I am gonna bounce our next performer. So our next performer this evening is Oren Gaskell from the state of Washington. Brother Oren is a member of 10 Mile Grange number 399. Oren says he is old enough to know better, but too young to resist, which I have to admit is a mindset that we might just have in common. Oren has been performing for over 70 years, having started as a wedding singer at the age of 5. Since then, he has sung as a soloist and choir member in churches and is currently a score dance caller, which includes singing some choreography. Please welcome Brother Oren Gaskell. Oren, the stage is yours.
Thank you, Chris. Okay. The first song I'm going to sing is an old classic that if you have listened to country music or pop music, you probably recognize it. There is a house in New Orleans, they call the Rising Sun. It has the ruin of many a poor boy, and I, O Lord, was one. My mother is a tailor, she sews those new blue jeans. My father is a gambler, Lord, way down in New Orleans. With one foot on the platform, the other on the train, I'm going back to New Orleans to wear a ball and chain. Go tell my baby brother, don't do what your brother done. Stay away from that house down in New Orleans, they call the Rising Sun. So the next one I'm going to sing is an old gospel song. I first sang this one in church at about age 15, give or take a couple. Some glad morning when this life is o'er, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die, hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away, just a few more weary days, and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days, and then I'll fly away. And I already flew away on that verse. When the shadows of this life have grown, I'll fly away. Like a bird from prison bars has flown, I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away in the morning when I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. The next song I sang to my wife at our wedding 23 years ago, and our children and my wife tell me that there wasn't a dry eye in the house when I got done with it. Now, I don't know why they were crying, but we're going to go with it anyway. Some say love, it is a river that drowns the tender reed. Some say love, it is a razor that makes the heart to bleed. Some say love, it is a hunger, an endless aching need. But I say love, it is a flower, and you, its only seed. It's the heart afraid of breaking that never takes the chance. It's the dream afraid of waking that never learns to dance. It's the one who won't be taken, who never learns to give. And the soul afraid of dying, who never learns to live. When the night has been too lonely and the road has been too long, and you think that love is only for the lucky and the strong, just remember in the winter, far beneath the bitter snow, lies the seed that with the sun's love in the spring becomes the rose. And the last one that I will do tonight is a tribute to grandfathers everywhere. My grandfather's clock was too large for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was taller by half than the old man himself, though it weighed not a penny weight more. It was bought on the morn of the day that he was born, and was always his treasure and his pride. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, tick tock, his life's seconds numbering, tick tock, but it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. In watching its pendulum swing to and fro, many hours had he spent as a boy. In childhood and manhood the clock seemed to know, and to share both his sorrow and joy. Oh, it struck 24 when he entered at the door with the beautiful blushing young bride. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. When the old man died. Thank you. You all have a good night now.
All right. Thanks, Oren. That was great. And thanks thanks for making the time and answering the call to join us tonight. That was fabulous. All right. Next up, we are going to head to North Carolina. And as I said earlier, this has been quite a trip around the country. We started in Texas, and then we went up to Washington State. Now we're headed all the way back crisscross to North Carolina, where we're going to have Baylor Howerton join us. Sister Baylor is 18, a member of Bushy Fork Grange number 1073, and she has been signing in Pigeon for about 5 years. Baylor says she was inspired by Granger's signing on stage, and now here she is. She hopes you enjoy this song written by One Republic that reminds us that there will be better days. Sister Baylor, take it away.
Hey, thank you for the introduction. So yeah, I just wanted to say that I wanted to do this song because it will remind us, no matter what fiasco we're going through right now, that there will be better days ahead. So.
Oh, I know that there'll be better days. Oh, that sunshine about to come my way. May we never, ever shed another tear for today. Waking up in California, but these clouds, they won't go away. Every day is like another storm, yeah. I'm just trying not to go insane. And the city shining so bright, so many dark nights, so many dark days. But anytime I feel the paranoia, I close my eyes and I pray. Oh, I know that there'll be better days. Oh, that sunshine. All right. Thanks, Baylor. That was great. Thanks for joining us tonight and representing North Carolina on Date Night In 11.0. So as a reminder, I didn't say it earlier, all of you out there should be well practiced by now, but remember that these folks cannot see you or hear you, so they are relying on you to go on Facebook and to leave them a bunch of love in the form of comments and emojis and everything else. You can jam in those lines so that they know you were listening and watching and enjoying their performances this evening. So I think we are going to head to Vermont, it looks like. We're still trying to get Joan on to join us. So tonight from Vermont is Lester Gibbs. Brother Les is a fourth generation Grange member joining in 1954 and currently a member of Upper Valley Community Grange number 581 in Norwich and of Blow Me Down number 234 in New Hampshire, a past master of the Vermont State Grange, as well as the current state musician for both Vermont and the New Hampshire State Granges. Wow, Les, you're a one busy guy. Les retired from the US Army in 1981 with 23 years of active duty. He has been an organist since the age of 16. Tonight, he is going to play three songs
on the three manual Austin pipe organ in the First Congregational Church of Woodstock, Vermont. Please put your hands together for Brother Lester Gibbs. Les?
Thank you, Chris, and I hope you'll enjoy the three pieces. The first one is a rather light piece by Johann Walter back in the late 1600s. The second piece is by William Walton. It's an elegy, it's a quieter piece. And the last piece is The Trumpet Voluntary by Jeremiah Clark, which is best known as the Prince of Denmark, played at many, many weddings. So, hope you enjoy. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Thanks, Brother Les. The only thing wrong with this tonight is I'm wishing that I was in Vermont to listen to that beautiful organ in person. I think that feeling it would be almost better than just listening to it. So thank you. Thank you very much. And that is our first organ as well in 11 weeks. So we keep adding more instruments and more performers from around the country. Are we ready? Joan, are you with us? All right. So I have already done the introduction. So we're gonna call that good to go. And like I was saying, Joan has agreed to join us and do a couple of impromptu speeches, one of which I get to pick the topic.
Okay.
Which Amanda is going to pick the topic. And I am going to start. And this is a softball for Joan, trust me. Joan, the first one tonight will be, tell us about your funniest experience en route to or from a Grange event.
You're right, you definitely got a softball for Joan. I've heard some of these stories, so she's gonna have lots to say.
All right. Well, if there's anybody on from New Jersey, they've heard this story before. It happened back when I was junior Grange co-director with Brother Paul Rabe, and some of you may remember him. He was a director of the New Jersey Junior Grange for, I think it was 37 years. Fabulous man. He was in his 80s and still doing Junior Grange director. And he had this impish little smile that the kids loved. And yet when he put his finger down or his foot down, everybody knew to listen up. So he and I were going out to Pennsylvania for some meeting that was held there in the wintertime, February or March. And I had a 19... Hello? Hello?
Yeah?
You're okay. Good, we can hear you.
I lost my picture. So I had a 1964 Chevy Nova. And on this trip out there, it was snowing most of the time. And the door, the passenger side door, decided to come off of its top hinge during this journey. So Paul Rabe and I had to drive on the Pennsylvania Turnpike with this door tied on to the dividing rod between the front seats and the back seat. We got a rope, we tied it up there, which of course meant the window was open. And as part of this, we're not sure what happened. The wipers stopped working. And this is all in the same journey home from Pennsylvania. We think the Pennsylvania folks probably did it. So I have to blame Wayne Campbell because it probably was some of those kids at this meeting or something. But then my windshield wipers wouldn't work. Well, in Pennsylvania, when there's snow in those days, and I don't know if this is still true, they used ash from the coal burning on the roads. Well, we couldn't see a thing on the Pennsylvania Turnpike. But I did have a gallon of that wonderful car wash stuff. So Paul Rabe, who then was in his late 60s, I would say, had to get out periodically because I couldn't get out because my door was tied shut to keep it on the car. He would get out and throw cleaner fluid onto the windshield and wipe it down as best we could. And off I go again until we couldn't see any longer. Now, we always did that. He told that story at New Jersey National Grange or State Grange Convention. And he had this impish little smile the whole time. Everybody loved it. It was a pretty harrowing experience. But when you talk about it and look back, how could all that go wrong with a Chevy 1965 Chevy Nova back in the 70s? So it was a harrowing experience, but it became a funny story in the state of New Jersey of Grange travels. I can't see a thing, so you say I'm still there.
You are indeed still here.
Okay.
Chris, I'm back. There you go. Chris, that was a good softball. And so mine is a little harder, but I thought that you might be able to bring in some current events or maybe our worthy lecturer into this. So your topic is fire or ice. And while you gather your thoughts, I'm going to do what they normally do at speech and debate contests. I'm just going to read something you, so you have a few seconds. It came from the idea of fire and ice, the poem from Robert Frost, where he says, some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. From what I've tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. But if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction, ice is also great and would suffice. So Joan, fire or ice?
Right, well, I made a couple of notes. And right now, first off, we have a fun event happening. I see Christine on the picture right now with our Grange Ice Bucket event. So that's a pretty current thing that's going on for the Grange. And I think probably we've had some great bucket ideas for, you know, trying to raise money here for the youth. So Chris and Dwayne this week, if you haven't seen it, as you know, she's a bigwig in the Washington State fire business. And her Gmail account says chief to be. So I'm sure that I think she's there already probably, or will be, or whatever her plans are. But this week they got a fire truck to stand behind them when they did the ice bucket challenge. And then she gave the clue to her lieutenants and out comes the hoses with water pouring on Chris and Dwayne. So they did the ice bucket challenge differently than anybody else has. But that was a challenge for our Grange youth. You see this sign behind me. These are all the things that the Grange Foundation does. Right now, we're trying to get the youth funded for 2021 and whatever they turn out to do in 2020. We sure would appreciate it if y'all would give $20 in 2020. You can even do it without doing the ice bucket. So the ice bucket is not necessarily required. Of course, we all love it. I haven't done it yet. I need to, but I have to do it when I'm getting ready to not have to set my hair. So we hope that a bunch of you will contribute to the youth fund. Fire brings to mind our 2019 camp revival. When we had nightly, most every camp grouping, and we were really different groups were there. We're all there together. But then in the evening, when it got dark, people kind of grouped up and did their own thing around their campfire, reminiscing. Or my group had 14 children, I shouldn't say children, teenagers down to 8-year-olds. So we had s'mores. And I'm sure that Chris and her gang over it in those fancy RVs had s'mores also. Well, we had a beautiful fire going. This was our Thursday night. I remember it well. And we had all of us sitting around the campfire in our chairs, 20 of us or so. And my nephew had brought some, he's a very funny guy. And he's done a lot of Grange talent in the past when he was a young man. And he's actually an attorney now and spoke on one of our videos a few weeks ago. But he had gotten some, something that he had in his hand. And he started doing the song from the Lion King. When they're dancing around the fire, he hopped up out of his chair and started dancing around the fire. And then he took his hand and threw stuff on the fire. And all of these beautiful colors illuminated the fire flames. And everybody, we were all oohing and aahing because we didn't know about it. It was so beautiful what he did And the kids were in awe. And here he is dancing around. And we all got up and started dancing around to that music and started all humming in. And some of the kids knew the words. I only know there's the musical part of it. And it was so much fun and experiences that all these Grange kids will never forget around that fire. And it was beautiful. And it wasn't that night when later in the evening that the very large, I think he was gigantic, must have been King Kong size bear, appeared behind our campfire. We didn't even know he was there. A camper, a non-Granger camper across the way, opened up his door to come out. We're all there making s'mores and happy as can be, happy as a lark around this beautiful fire. And this other camper comes out and he screams bear. And it was about 15 feet behind our fire circle. So it was quite exciting for the kids. Well, very exciting for all of us to have this bear join us around our Grange fire. So he was so excited about the Puma music, I'm sure, from Lion King that we were all attempting to sing, and these gorgeous colors of our fire that he couldn't resist joining our group. So we decided that he was going to be we called our camping group the Ramblin' Grangers, and we made him part of our group. So that's a fire story and an ice story. And thank you all very much. They said I have 5 minutes and I am there. Thank you.
That was awesome, Joan. All right. So if you have a natural talent like Joan's, which is speaking, you are more than welcome on this program, right, Chris?
Absolutely. Thanks, Joan, for stepping into the fray there and not knowing exactly what we were going to throw at you. So what a great sport and what some great stories. Thanks for sharing. And yeah, like Amanda said, if any of you out there are wanting to do something, share something, share your talents with us, we'd love to have you over the next several weeks. So get in touch with us and let us know. And before we say goodbye this evening, I just want to make sure that we do a final shout out to Corinne and to Oren and to Baylor and Lester and to Joan for joining us this evening and sharing your talents. And again, the love for what you do and your willingness to share that is been great. And that's what makes these events so fun is the fact that every one of you always just has a great time and that's why all of those folks are out there watching. It's not to watch me and probably not to watch Amanda, although she's the reason that we all get this done, but it's to see the great talent that Grangers have and you know, we've done this for 11 weeks. We've talked about it, right? And we've averaged probably, what, Amanda, 5 acts a night?
Yep.
So in my math, that's 55 acts and 55 different acts. There's nobody that's been on twice yet. And in my mind, there shouldn't have to be. There's 55 is not even scratching the surface of the talented Grangers that we have across the country. And so I would keep challenging everybody to get a hold of us and find us and come on and take a few minutes and share, you know, share your talents with us. But I don't see us slowing down. What do you think, Amanda?
I would say we should be doing this for at least another couple of weeks. I can't imagine that there is not more talent out there. And now that they're seeing the variety and breadth, I think that they can find their way to slot right. themselves in.
Right. You know, you can be inside or outside. I mean, we've shown that. And there's still some instruments that we haven't had. I think now that some of the states and some of the counties have relaxed some of their meeting numbers, that maybe there can be some more groups, or you know, give us a group from a Grange Hall. I know in our state, you can't be gathered with more than five people outside of your household, but that could get you a small group in a Grange Hall or in somebody's backyard or something. So be creative, get some folks together, have some fun, and come on Saturday night with us.
And I just wanted to say one last thing, which is I'm really glad that Joan got on and you got to see her face, because she is the chairperson of the Grange Foundation, and Grange Foundation has been the one sponsoring all of these live stream events and making sure that we're both entertained and educated during this time. And these are things that we can share over and over again. So it was really neat to have her on here and show a different talent, but also just to include her in something that she's been a really big proponent of for this whole time. So.
Absolutely. Absolutely. That's the fun part, is this has been a great chance for folks from juniors on up to showcase talents that are just being learned, to talents that have been honed over decades and decades. You know, that's the fun part. And that's exactly what I remember from my upbringing in Grange, is being, that's the first place outside of my bedroom that I played my saxophone, was in a Grange Hall. And you learn how to perform and you know, all the things that go along with that. So again, think about who's out there in your Granges that you think would be great addition to Date Night In, and get in touch with us and get them in touch with us, and we'll make sure that the train just keeps rolling.
Awesome. Thank you everybody for joining us this evening. We look forward to more talent next week. We've already got a few signed up, so consider joining us. And last thing I should say is, Chris, you, Betsy, Phil Prelli, a bunch of you have already taken this ice bucket challenge, but live on Monday night, we're going to get to see a few more. So that's kind of exciting. I don't know if anybody's going to pop getting a fire truck dumping some water on them, but we'll see. So join us back here again for our next episode. And you can check out all of the episode listings on our patrons chain or on our website. And have a great night, everybody.
All right.